want to be careful that the patients aren't starting to get the notices that you and I were talking about earlier with, you know, this patient isn't on a whatever.
Right. Yeah.
Because then you get alert fatigue.
Right. Sure. Yeah. Absolutely.
So maybe the last question here, and very much related, is we have a lot of change in the payment landscape, and some of you have mentioned some of the problems of payment, some of the new ways in which we're paying, you know, anything from accountable care organizations of different flavors, right, to bundled payment, episode-based payment, total cost of care, et cetera, et cetera. This is an equal alphabet soup. For care for diabetes patients, thoughts on whether any of these new payment models are really influencing any of the practice that's being delivered?
I think they're starting to, and I believe that the promise is really great in this area, particularly if the time horizon is long enough, because, you know, in the end, we know how to prevent a large part of the complications and essentially a large part of the cost related to diabetes by getting better blood sugar control, cholesterol control, blood pressure control, screening for complications. Often, if you look at the numbers, you know, nationally, they're quite poor in terms of the, you know, percentage of individuals with diabetes that meet all those different characteristics. And the interventions that would get you there are happen to be ones that really there's little or no reimbursement for. Mm-hmm. And so if the shift is really about lowering long-term costs, which is, you know, really in the end, the total cost of care, all these models are based on, that allows a shifting of resources in a direction where you can invest in the types of things that we know are effective.
Over that period of time,
yeah.
And again, in the managed care space, we enter into and create a lot of these shared risk agreements with upsides, where the downstream savings are split between the plan and the IPA hospital or provider. And so at WellCare, we design a lot of our value-based purchasing contracts on that principle. And a lot of our PCMH providers, same principle. How can we incentivize you to move the needle for quality, improve outcomes, member experience, but at the same time save money downstream?
Right. So I think what's missing in the equation is getting the pharmaceutical industry to really participate in this and have some way for managed care and industry to get essentially revenue neutral ways of providing all the medicines that a given individual or that a population of individuals will need so that they can receive what we now consider to be optimal care and not break the bank. Yeah. And I think it's possible. We've got these ideas. Industry wants to provide the new medicines. There are all kinds of negotiations. Too many people are left actually paying full retail and suffering. But we could see a light at the end of the tunnel where we'll be able to get the good medicines for glycemic control, lipids, blood pressure to the patients to really promote the health that we want.
But even if you look at data from CMS, the United States is the superpower in the world, and we have the highest medical cost, but yet our quality is not matching that. So we make all these agents available to the public, but yet our quality, despite the fact that all these tools are available, our quality and our outcome performance just isn't there.
But from the health system perspective, you know, the financial incentives are in an opposite direction. I mean, that's shifting now,
right,
which is good.
Right.
But obviously in the old fee-for-service model, the inadvertent investments in building more OR space,
volume rather than value.
It's you know, for better or worse, complication care is a money making business.
Yes.
Complication prevention is a money losing business.
Yeah. Right.
And that until that shifts, that's really going to be the thing that will change things. And I think it's happening. And as risk is being shifted to healthcare organizations to manage themselves.